Hi, I'm Tom. I'm here to guide you through the online training videos. In this video, we will be looking at the MTX multi-zone audio matrix. Due to the amount of content, I'll be splitting this video into parts. In this specific video, we will be looking at the web control abilities of the MTX. There are two different options. The first is the website that comes built into the device, and the other is the audac touch app. First, we will be looking at the website. After logging in, you will come to the main screen, which provides you with a great overview of the zones available. Here you have the mute buttons, volume sliders, input selection, and zone indication. We can highlight the text zone 1 and replace it with whatever text we wish. A simple left click and the zone is muted. If we click on the box that says mic 1, this is what we call the quick drop-down menu. Here we can select an input to use for this zone. If we want to, we can turn some of these inputs off. Why would this be useful? This menu is used by the MWX45 wall panel. Any input set to off, the wall panel will skip as you scroll up and down through its inputs. Moving on to the setup screen. Paging volume. Here we can set the volume level of each zone when paging. Mono stereo can be selected here, and it's selectable for each zone individually. Priority settings. The MTX has two priority inputs, one for each mic. We can adjust the hold time before the music returns. The input sensitivity has three level settings, and the volume level of the mic for each zone is selectable. Your network settings. If you make any adjustments here, the moment you click off, they will be applied. System configuration. Here is where you can program all the extra devices connected to the MTX. From left to right. Address. Every MWX65 must be unique here. You have 8 to choose from. This means you can have up to 8 MWX65 wall panels for an MTX88 and 4 for an MTX48. Each wall panel can control one zone. Here you can collect the zone you need to control. Selectable inputs. Here you can add any and all combinations of inputs you like. Function blocking. Is the wall panel being installed in a public place? No problem. You can block any type of function you like. Phantom power can be set to on as a default if needed or on demand via the setting menu on the wall panel. When you are satisfied with your settings, just hit save to wall panel. All the settings will remain on the screen, so if you have a lot to program and they are all the same, no problem. Just address the next and hit save to wall panel. MWX45 and 43. This wall panel will control the one zone, and that zone is selectable here. They need no address, so the amount you can use is unlimited. APM. Default, the APM is fully programmable via the website. Here you can see the address for when using more than one. You can also select the priority for each table and the volume levels of the mic chime. The Configure APM button will set all the selected settings. When using the audac system manager, the APM becomes fully programmable. MPX. This has the same paging functions as the APM, but not programmable. Even via the system manager, it's not programmable. Front controls. The MTX is controllable via the controls of the front panel, but that's not always wanted. So audac has added a block function. For volume, input, bass, and treble. Using this freely available solution, application-specific dashboards can be created and customized, allowing the control for multiple devices from one single application. Let's have a look at the widgets available for the MTX series. Input select widget. This widget controls the input selection of one zone. The selection options match the quick menu on the matrix for that zone. Mute widget. Very straightforward. This widget mutes the zone that it is set to control. Volume widget. This widget will provide you with a volume slider to a given zone. Nice when you only have one input or do not want other users to change the input. Zone name widget. This displays the name of the given zone. It can be used in combination with any of the widgets we've just talked about. Zone widget. This is an all-in-one widget. Everything we've just talked about in one. Input, volume, name, and mute. The default dashboards use these widgets.